Hello, dissenters. Welcome back to Slime Rancher, where we're just jumping down the tunnel tube into regions unknown, scary lands, foreign, as far as the eye can see. What on earth is over here? Some strange lava slimes and a gold slime that I can't seem to vacuum up. Maybe we need a better vac pack, and it's gone just as quickly as it appeared. So what do we have here? A lot of tabbies. And we're taking water. There's a pond here. We can just vacuum up water. I guess to use as ammunition against the tars. But what are you? Maybe... Oh dear, we've got monstros already. We've got tar slimes. And we've got spoiled Q-berries that are not wanting to be vacuumed up. Fair enough. Okay, well let's dump the rock slimes. And see if we can... No, we can't absorb you either. Okay, well we'll take the rock slimes back then, I guess. It looks like we're not able to really do much over here, except perhaps kill the tar slimes by splashing them with water. Have a little bit of that action. We're gonna try our first attempt at actually killing these guys. This just turned into a first-person shooter. Look at that. You didn't think I was armed and dangerous, did you? Don't worry, slimes. Etalyx is here to protect you. We're just gonna shoot bobbles of water. There we go, the splash damage did it for us. Now I think you will not fit because I've got too much stuff right now, but maybe, there we go, boom slime. Careful, these slimes have been known to, hopefully they don't explode while I'm holding them. Let's go a little further. I feel like I have to know what is around the next corner. Let's take some more booms. I mean, these are brand new slimes, aren't they? We gotta collect them, forget the rock slimes. What is that? I don't even know, we don't have enough space. I guess I could drop the Q-berries, but it's just not worth it to me right now. And there's a tunnel in here? What is... Okay, those are some baddies. Let's just start running the other direction now. I think night is about to fall and the tars are getting a little out of hand. Well, I know this much. I don't go back the way I came. I wonder if there's a way to loop around. Maybe we have to keep going this way. I have no choice. I must press forward. Splash the tars. Try to keep them. They're already dominating the landscape. There is no question in my mind about that, but I won't let them absorb me so quickly. Maybe we can just navigate through these alert, electro-shocking pink slimes. Just keep going. Water fountains! You can absorb water from these. Things are a little calmer over here. I've restocked with 20 water from the nearby spout, spigot. I found something interesting, a new fruit, mint mango. Cool. Still don't know what these slimes are. We'll find out later. Chickadees? Pink slimes dropping from the heavens? These like earthy looking slimes are all over the place out here. And this is still going. I feel kind of bad just running through the whole area, not really like soaking it in, but at the moment there's not like an easy way to get back home. So I have to keep going forward. We've seen at least 4 new types of slimes out here though. All in need of herding. Hang on. Is this what I saw before when I could have dropped off of the edge? I don't know. Perhaps so. That button has to do something, right? And this area is under construction and it's gonna need a key, so that must be just in development. Whoa, what? We did it! We're home! It was a teleporter! Okay, I was right to go even further out now. Now, what do the boom slimes do? We're gonna have to read about them. Let's put them all in the extra super secure kennel here. And take a look at the Slimepedia. So boom slimes love meat and briar hens, and they're constantly building towards inevitable explosions. And they'll knock nearby slimes into the air, and they're difficult to corral. So they are going to have some really good plorts. We just have to give them meat. Now, I feel like to make this game more interesting and difficult, I shouldn't be able to feed them any type of meat. Like, these guys are one of the more rare ones, compared to the others at least, especially compared to tabby slimes, which also will eat meat. I feel like they shouldn't give me their really rare plort unless I give them their actual favorite food. That would make this game much more challenging and more focused on exploration and collecting various types of animals. What do you guys think? So if they're constantly building towards an explosion, are we safe on the other side of the wall? And what is happening over in this funhouse? How long before they break through that net? They are so fat. They're taking up so much space. We gotta start using our money. We gotta start building up the corrals. And we need more chickens to feed all of these meat lovers. Okay, so I've clearly got some goals, don't I? I think we need to take at least one chicken over to our new slime type and see what they do and feed these chums some heartbeats. I want all of your plorts. So I'm gonna let them jump around, do their thing. Yes, it can damage me through the wall if I get too close. Okay, let's take one little hen. Preferably an older hen, but we don't have one of those on hand. And see how much one of these ports is worth. Now this is the one we need the music box for to calm them, I bet. Let's try it out. Be calm, my little exploding slimes. Free of all of your anger. Don't be upset or explode. Nobody's building towards an inevitable explosion. Okay, they are! I spoke too quickly. I don't know what the music box is for then. And I don't want you to tell me. I'll figure it out. Don't worry. Now, what was that worth? 57 coins! That's over double what my other producers are worth. How do we make these greens and these golds? That must be the earth slime. That must be the water slime. These are so valuable. Oh, we're gonna have to definitely make more excursions out there into the wild unknown. I'm so excited. And at the same time, I need a plort collector here very badly because the plort collector will gather two types of plorts so that I don't have to get in there in the thick. I am going to die so quickly if I get in here. Look at this. Okay, hang on guys, don't mind me, I just want your plorts. See, it's impossible, I can't do it. You have to have the plort collector. Plort collection is going to be very, very handy for us. I wanna do some science here because I'm thinking that since heartbeats are the favorites of the rock slimes, ow, that we should now, per feeding, get two rock plorts and one tabby slime plort. So, if I am correct, then we will have, oh, hey guys. What's up, friends? You can't get in there. You know better than that, and I've, no. You're not allowed to eat those plorts now. I've gotta put you in this pen with all the others. I'm gonna start exploding this here pretty soon. Okay, hang on, hold that thought, guys. There's gotta be a better way to do this. No. They're all getting out. They're all transforming. I know it's so tasty, but you gotta just stay in your pins. We gotta upgrade this right now to high walls. There. That's gonna solve the problem. In the short term, we're gonna go fix the tabby in just a moment. I need to make sure that this heartbeat is used to replant here. Because why do we need carrots, right? Oh, actually, hang on. Did that even work? I don't see any of the tiny little heart plants. I think I might have screwed something up here. Everything's just getting out of control. What? Why is this getting so difficult all of a sudden? The rock slimes are out here doing I don't know what, but we have a spot now to absorb them. I guess there was a little piece of food. Get back in here, guys. I'm gonna have to double size your walls too. It's high time. It's high time. Get it? I dumped a load of carrots in here just to get rid of them, to feed the rock slimes, make them happy and content. We're eventually going to use this cage for something else, I'm sure. But I also preemptively installed a plort collector because we're eventually going to use this corral for some hybrid slimes, no doubt. So I'm just preparing in advance. Now, 3 out of 4 of these cages have vacuums. Let's check this one out. We got 21 of our rock plorts. And that means we'll be able to hold most of them in 22. So no, science was incorrect. I am not getting double blue plorts from feeding heartbeats. Okay, but I just had to know. You know, there was no way for me to really tell. So we're gonna cash in all these plorts and we're going to do two important things for the ranch. Number one is at this farm where I was previously attempting to grow some more heartbeats, I think instead a smart idea is to grow Q-berries. So let's make a Q-berry tree. And secondarily, let's do something a lot of you have probably been wanting to check out, the jetpack. It's a mere 250 coins. Why are these upgrades so cheap? I could upgrade almost all of them just in one good harvest. The jetpack should be at least like 2,000, maybe more, maybe 5,000. That seems like a big deal. All of these should be at least a few thousand. But regardless, let's strap the jetpack on and go all Team Rocket up in here. So how does this thing even work? Do we double tap? Not just some big rocket boost. We probably just hold it down. That's not gonna get us that much height, is it? about as tall as the double strength walls here, but it uses our endurance at the bottom left, so getting a better power core is going to let us fly higher. I see how this is integrated now. That's pretty smart. I was thinking it was just going to let me sprint further, and there's another one that halves sprinting cost as well. I wonder if that affects the jetpack. Not 100% certain. Let's go check on a couple of our plort collectors now, and I want to fast forward through time to get the heartbeats and check on the phosphors. You guys will just have to excuse me for getting all confused. Apparently, I am an old man who doesn't remember anything, because Q-berries are the favorite of my friends, the phosphor slimes, and heartbeats, by contrast, are the favorites of Mr. Rock Slime here. So let's get some double action on the plort production here. Take one of our Q-berries, we planted the other one already, down to the phosphor cave. Let's see how our old friend's doing. It's been some time, hasn't it? Are they still here? There's only five of them left. All of the phosphors that I collected are gone. The trees have sprouted. Some of you have indeed warned me of a bug whereby putting slimes in these extensions for some reason inexplicably start disappearing over time. There's no rhyme or reason for it. It's kind of sad, I confess, but there's nothing I can really do. So let's plant Q-berries here in the tree and use our newfound slot pick up what phosphors we can. Not the phosphor actual slimes. I don't need you guys. I just want your valuable plorts. Now, I guess it doesn't matter whether they're roaming free or whether they are caged up. That just seems like something the developers are going to have to fix in due time. Sadly, we had 25 or 30 almost phosphor slimes in here. I guess we weren't taking good enough care of them. I thought plant fruit was good enough, but no, they've all starved to death. I think they just vanish. These are 27 apiece, currently more than either of the others that we're producing, giving us a whopping 1367. So let's head out again, see if we can find anything with our new jetpack. But most importantly, I want to increase the power core here so that we can boost even higher in theory. Let's give it a moment to recharge and see if it works. All right, so we can just hover around Inspector Gadget style. There is just trash everywhere. Plorts and berries and chickens. As far as the eye can see, this looks like a spot we might be able to elevate to. Let's try using the old jetpack here. Is there any secrets up above, or is it just a platform to walk upon? Yeah, it looks pretty default basic. How much higher can we go? What is that? Is that an oil slime? Is that a tar? For now, it seems that the jetpack is functional, but there's not a whole lot of interaction with the environment yet. So I can't wait till in the future it's a little bit more dense and vertical so that we can use the jetpack to get to areas that we've been walking through this whole time, but that hold new treasures up high above. But we'll do some more exploring with the jetpack tomorrow. Thank you guys again for joining me on this adventure in Slime Rancher. It was fun going to the new zone, capturing our first boom slimes, and hopefully we'll be able to return and show everyone who's boss, gather up all the new slimes, and make some new slime babies. Thank you so much for watching, guys. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time back at the ranch.